I believe it's true, 'cause I can see his love when I look at you. And he must have a plan for this crazy life, 'cause he brought you here and placed you by my side. And I have never been so sure of anything before like I am in this moment here with you. Now for better or for worse, so much more than only words. And I pray every day will be the proof that I mean what I say. You see, these hands you hold will always hold you up when the strength you have just ain't strong enough. And what tomorrow brings, only time will tell. But I will stand by you in sickness and in health.
Gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Take your bride by the hand. You both just. Let me just face me for a second. All right. These are very uncertain times, obviously. Very unique days. Obviously, the restrictions are in place. You can't do this the way that typically and traditionally weddings are done. A lot of family and friends watching from a distance. The ceremony may be modified, but the relationship and the sanctity of marriage is not. What you are entering into today is not a modified relationship. It is the same holy and pure covenant of lifelong fidelity that has been made and given to people throughout the centuries. And so marriage is honorable, and it is deserving of respect, it's deserving of preparation, it's deserving of prayer and careful consideration. So we are entering in this today with our eyes wide open and with full awareness that you are beginning a life together. That life that you will build is based on the trust and the love that you have grown to discover with one another. And that's the foundation. The marriage ceremony is significant in that it is taking vows and covenants in front of God and these witnesses. My prayer for this ceremony today was that although many of your family couldn't be here to witness it, the presence of God would be here to witness it. And so you are standing before God, and you are standing before this small gathering to make covenants that will last until this life is over. And marriage is honorable. The Apostle Paul types it to the relationship of the Church of Christ. So we know that it is extremely honorable if God uses it as a sample of what his relationship with his bride is. It's not to be entered into casually or carelessly. It's to be entered into prayerfully, carefully, and with much counsel and consideration, which you both have endeavored to do to this point. So, as Genesis states in 2 and 24, therefore shall a man leave his father and his mother, and shall cleave unto his wife, and they shall be one flesh. So today this man Ben Kane, and this woman, Jenny Wang, to come together for the purpose of this sacred union. So Ben, would you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in holy covenant of marriage? Would you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jenny, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the holy covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
All right, Ben, will you repeat this vow to your bride? I, Ben Kane, take you, Jenny Wang.
I, Ben Kane, take you, Jenny Wang.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poor.
For richer, for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are separated by death.
Until we are separated by death.
As God is my witness.
As God is my witness.
I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
Jenny, will you repeat this vow to your groom? I, Jenny Wang, take you, Ben Kane.
I, Jenny Wang, take you, Ben Kane.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For
richer, for poor. In sickness and in health. To love and to cherish. Until we are separated by death. As God is my witness, I give you my promise. Now both to Ben and Jenny, do you mutually promise in the presence of God and these witnesses that you will at all times and in all circumstances conduct yourselves toward one another in a godly representation of husband and wife?
It says in Mark 9:15 that salt is good, but if the salt has lost its saltiness, wherewith will the season? Have salt in yourselves and be one with another. Salt is known for many properties, including bringing flavor, melting ice, and being a preservative. In biblical times, people would often perform a salt covenant to symbolize how inseparable they and their lives would become. Today, Ben and Jenny have chosen to participate in the salt covenant. Now, how do we, assuming the salt covenant, do they want they and their lives to reflect God on a daily basis together? They are also weaving their lives together today. Going forward, if ever there's a time when Ben or Jenny needs, they can look to their container and remember how tied together they are. May they have a long life together that's full of flavor and knowledge.
Let's pray. Let's ask the blessings and favor of God upon this relationship. I'm going to lay my hands on you and pray for you. I'm going to ask this group of folks to assemble that have assembled with us to lift their voices and let's pray together that God's blessing and favor would be upon this union going forward. Father, we come to you right now in your precious name. God, we ask your blessing and your favor upon Ben and Jenny. God, I pray that you would bless their relationship, give them wisdom to understand one another, to love one another, support and strengthen one another. God, I pray that you would give them a deep abiding love for you and for your truth, and that their home would always stand for your kingdom, your righteousness, God, and your truth. I pray, God, as you prosper them and as they go forward in life, that any children they would bear, that would raise them in the fear and the admonition of the Lord, God, training them as they have been trained by their families to walk in truth and righteousness. God, I pray you would anoint Ben with the wisdom beyond his years to understand how to navigate and lead his home. into righteousness. God, I pray that you would give Jenny the spirit of wisdom and understanding.